story.
Oh.
Your name first.
My name is Ben.
Ben.
From the Netherlands. And in 1974 of the last century, previous century, I decided to stop my job and my study and to leave Holland with a backpack, not knowing why, but traveling to the east like many young people and older people used to do at that time. It was the hippie trail.
Yeah.
Now they all go to Santiago. At that time they all went to the east. And I didn't know why I went. But when I was in India, I went through Iran, Turkey, Iran, Afghanistan, Pakistan, yeah. India. And I saw people dying in India. I saw suffering. I saw they burned the dead, literally. And then I knew why I was traveling. My question was, what is the purpose of life? Why do I live? I looked in philosophy, I looked in religions. I thought if I would have been born in India, I would have been a Hinduist. So why should I now be Catholic or Protestant? Didn't make sense. I looked in culture, I looked in nature, I looked there, I looked here. And I ended up exactly at the other side of the world, very disillusioned because I didn't find the purpose of life. And I thought, if I travel on, I go direction home again, what I don't want. But if I start to travel back, I also go direction home. So I got stuck at the other side of the world. And the key is, I was at the end of myself.
Which part of the world?
Indonesia.
Wow.
I was at the end of myself. And that's the key. I see many pilgrims. My stomach goes around when I see pilgrims telling me, I'm looking for myself. I'm almost there. They try. And the harder they try, the more the goal runs away from them. Yeah. And then they try harder and they never find it. And yes. I talk with them in Santiago and they tell me, I didn't find myself. I say, you walked 750 kilometers on your own. You didn't find yourself. I was there. When you start with yourself, you end up with yourself.
Yes.
It's just as simple as that. So I was there at the other side of the world. Somebody came to me and said to me, you know what? You cannot find the purpose of life. I said, thank you. You should have told me 1 year earlier. I found out now by myself, by my own experience. But that person said, do you know the good news? I said, what do you mean good news? In the Greek language, good news is F, is good, news, angelio. Evangelio. Evangelio?
Yeah. Angel?
No.
Evangelio.
Evangelio.
Yes. The gospel.
Yeah. It means good news. So when I heard that Evangelio, I was, religious person, I passed that station. Don't come too close, otherwise I'll hit you. If God is love, why people suffer and die? There's no. The person looked at me quietly and said, you think religion is good news? It's a very bad news. You have to go to church, you have to keep the rules, to follow the traditions. Not for me. Person said, the good news is not something that you do, it's something that has been done for you. And I said, what do you mean has been done for me? And that person said, well, the creator of heaven and earth, in the first place, he created heaven and earth, which is not a small thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Whatever you believe,
yeah,
it's not a small thing.
Yeah.
And in the second place, the creator of heaven and earth, he came in his world, in Jesus, who lived, died, rose from the dead, revealed himself to his disciples, and it says in the Bible, he's the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Yeah.
Now, how can he be the same yesterday, today, and forever, if he was just an historical person who lived 2,000 years ago?
Yeah.
So that made me think, and that person said, it's not about religion, what you do, it's about something that you cannot do, and it is restoring the relation with God the Creator. And our human nature cannot do that by itself. That's why Jesus died, because we couldn't do it. And he died not just to forgive us from our sins, but to give us a new life.
Yeah.
It says in the Gospel of John, for those who received him, they become a child of God, not born of flesh or the will of a man, but born of God. I didn't believe it. I couldn't believe it, didn't want to believe it. The person left, had shown me from the gospel clearly, I saw this that the person was sincere, but I didn't believe it. Then I was alone on the boat 5 days, going back, and then I thought to myself, I've tried everything, nothing worked. I have nothing to lose. if faith is trust, which it is,
yes,
I thought, why not try?
Yes.
So I said aloud, I don't believe, I cannot believe, it is not for me, but if it's true, will you show me?
Yes.
The moment I made that step with my heart, it was for me super difficult to make that step because I was a logical, stubborn, proud, scientific Dutch guy. No one is going to fool me. But when I made that step, suddenly I still cannot describe in words what happened. Peace, joy, love, hope, purpose of life, my identity, my destination. I found a new life in Jesus.
Yes.
And not I found it. The song says, amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, and not now I found it, but now I am found.
Yeah.
A girl from England said to me, so you think you found it? I said, that's what I'm saying. I didn't find it, but I was at the end of myself, and then he found me. And he changed my life from the inside out. He changed my thinking, my feelings. For weeks I felt that I was not in this world. And that I'm now sitting here with you sharing this, it blows my mind.
Yes.
I never thought this day would come, that I, who traveled around the world as a hippie with a backpack, I have lived 23 years in a Mediterranean country, I'm from a Catholic background, and I feel like everything that happened in my life before, good and bad, all has worked towards this point that I feel really happy. And now people here say to me, you look so happy, look, you tilted yourself,
yeah, yeah.
You're so happy, I don't know. But I don't know, I know it, and I feel the obligation, not that I have to do it, but I like to see people happy. I say,
yeah,
to pilgrims, forget about me, I will never see you again in my life, but I know that this message, which in Europe has become an old-fashioned thing, tradition, religion, Jesus is the same, and he's changing lives, and I see it happening before my eyes.
Yes.
I see it happening.
Yes.
God is working in the Camino, incredible things. And so many young people, they got stuck in all kind of, they make their own beliefs, they believe, they prepare to believe anything, and especially when it's something foreign, but Jesus said, yo soy el camino.
Yes, yes.
I'm the way.
Yeah.
I'm the truth. I'm,
yeah,
the life. Nobody comes to the Father than through me. So there are two possibilities. Or he didn't know what he was saying, or he said something that we cannot understand by ourselves, only received by faith.
Yeah.
And I made that decision when I was 22, and I've looked back in my life. I will not say I never had problems, but I've experienced, like Jesus said, I will be with you always.
Yes.
And he's with us when we want him to be with us. He's not going to push, he's a gentleman. He knocks at the door of our heart and he wants to come in, but he's not going to force the door.
Yeah.
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 But exactly. I am surprised, while I was like that when I was 23, I talk now with young pilgrims and they say, thank you, I've never heard this before. Thank you for sharing. I couldn't believe it.
Yeah. No.
I couldn't believe it.
You're so right.
And that was just the beginning, was not, now I believe, that's it. Many pilgrims, they say to me from about the purpose of life, there is no standard answer. I said, of course not. We all have a different fingerprint. We have to find out for ourselves. But the Bible says, who search will find. And that person in Indonesia gave me the Bible, didn't try to push or pull or try to convince me. I would never have. Gave me the Bible and said, you know, find out for yourself.
Yeah.
If you want to find gold, you have to dig for yourself and get it out of the ground.
Yeah.
So simple, so simple.
Yeah. And tell me, how do you want to say a little bit about your wife, how and your life with her, and then after her death, and how you coped with all of that?
Man,
it's a long story.
Yeah, it's a long story. I'll try to summarize it. But so I started to travel back on a big ferry boat in Indonesia, 500 Indonesian people. And I was the only white person on deck.
Wow.
And you were crossing to...
From Ambon to Surabaya, 5 days. And I can show you a picture when I was 22. I looked like Bin Laden with a beard and Indian dress. And I was... And people... There was a team on the boat who came from a revival in Indonesia where 10,000 of people had become believers in the biggest Muslim country in the world. And they were traveling on that boat and they saw this Dutch guy, the only foreigner on board. And they came to me one by one. I didn't know they knew one another. And there was one former Hinduist, there was a former Buddhist, and a Muslim, and they all shared about Jesus, how Jesus changed their life. And I was like on a chair where three legs are cut off. What's happening in one day, three main religions? The fourth person had already heard from the first three that I was a hopeless case, a Dutch logical guy, no way. So the fourth person came prepared. And that person listened to my questions. If God exists, why they're suffering? Why? So people who don't believe, yeah, like you, they go to hell. I was just shooting. And the person just listened. And I felt this person is really interested in what I ask. And try to give, and not that the person had all the answers, but at least listened. Well, so I received Jesus. My life changed completely. I kept corresponding with this fourth person for 3 years. Corresponding, no internet, no mobile, no. I sent a letter, 3 weeks to arrive there, 3 weeks to have an answer. So I wrote every 2 weeks a letter. And by the time I had written 5 letters, I got the letter back. And I checked it off. Oh, this is an answer to my first letter. And that for 3 years. Then I invited that person to come to Holland. And we married.
Really?
Oh my God!
No way! What was her name?
I was not looking for a woman. I was 22. I wanted to see the world. She was not looking for a husband. But God afterwards prepared my heart and we married. And then in Holland. And then after 10 years we moved to Greece. And we have done there a lot of help to a lot of people with the crisis, the refugee crisis, the economical crisis, different Albania, the revolution in Albania. We just helped. We just have a heart to help. And if you have when you have a heart to help, the problems will come on your way.
Yeah.
Like now, you get people who have problems with their legs and here on the leg. The problems will come on your way.
What was your wife's name?
Esther.
Esther.
Esther. She was for me an example. But the fact, 5 years ago, she went to the Lord. Of course, that's a difficult experience when you lose your partner. It's very difficult. But she went to the Lord.
Yeah.
I'm 69. How many years I still have to go?
Yeah. Exactly.
And finally, you can have the best relation in the world. We're 38 years married, happily married, but we came into this world separately and we leave this world separately. So we better have to learn that you can have the most perfect relation, but there is a part that only God can fill.
Yeah.
There's a part that the Creator himself wants to fill, because as the Creator, he likes, as long as he made us, to have a relation.
Yes, relation. Exactly.
Man, I see really need today, many people in Holland too, many people totally lost, totally dissing their own gods and just totally mixed up. And the end, the gospel is so simple, in fact so simple. I'm quite philosophical, sometimes I complicate things, but in fact it's simple, trust and follow Jesus.
Exactly.
Last week I got a message from a girl, she wrote, Ben, you have a childlike faith, but you have wisdom like a 69-year-old man. And I thought, yeah, that really fits me. I do crazy things, and sometimes crazy things, but when we do things in faith and trust, we can see how God is blessing that.
Yes, for sure. It's amazing story, like, and for future generations, you will remember the video.
Yeah, so for me, that it was my wife who had the courage in her broken English to come to the deck of the ship where I was with my sleeping bag. I looked like Bin Laden. And she had the courage to tell me about Jesus. That gives me so much comfort and courage to talk now to a young generation.
And
I cannot say this without tears.
And was she in Indonesian? Really? Wow. That is amazing. That is really amazing. I think more people need to understand the passion we have for Christ, because he's not an intellectual person. He's not an intellectual concept.
It's not the knowledge, it's heart.
Heart. Yeah. And you live differently. People who believe live differently.
Yeah,
like we see life differently,
And not just this life, we know, like Jesus said, who believes has eternal life.
Yes.
And that's not after we die. When we receive him, the living God, we didn't receive a theory or a dogma. We received the living Creator.
Yes.
So it's not, I always thought, when somebody believes, he enters in a kind of prison and he has to do things that he doesn't like. It's outside yourself.
Yes.
But when I believed, it was exactly the opposite. I came out of the limitation of myself as human being into a freedom that I'd never known before, and that I live every day.
I like that. How you explained that is really good.
I was 3 years ago, after my wife died, I went to Budapest, into the metro down. And there I went to travel to the Balkan countries, and I just wanted to see, I said it to my children in Holland, I want to see where God is working. It's so many problems in the Balkans, always wars. Is God working or not? And where he's working? And I go into the metro and I see a boy standing there. And I had just been in Czechia, in Prague, at a conference of 10,000 Christian young people from all European countries. And I see there a boy standing so quiet, and he looks at me so peaceful. While the people are running, some million people in Budapest. And I look a second time, beams of love from his eyes, passion, compassion, empathy. I don't know how to describe it. It was as if I was looking into the sea in his eyes. And I said, what's this? So I look the other direction again, and look again. Man, beams of love. Still he was there. It was like Jesus looking to me. I've never experienced something like it. So I thought, what shall I do? I said, but my purpose was to see where God is working. I have to do, it was like a moment of destination. I have to do something with this. I cannot leave it. But what shall I do? So shall I walk up to him and ask him whether he's a Christian or not? Then he will say yes or no. So what? So I was thinking, it's 1 minute perhaps, but it looked like eternity. And I walk up to him and I said, why are you so friendly? And he said, I love Jesus. And somehow I knew it already. It could be a drug addict. I don't know. But I felt like it was a recognition in the spirit. I said, what's your name? He said, Emmanuel. God is with us. Now, if you read in the Bible, God is with us, okay. But if you're in the underground 100 meter in Budapest, where it's very deep, and there you hear God is with us, okay. And he asked me, where are you from? I said, I'm from Holland, but I've just come from a conference in Prague, in Czechia, where 10,000 young people gathered from all European countries. He looked at me and he said, I was there too.
No.
I traveled with him on the metro. It really happened. Eh? I traveled with him on the metro and I said, do you mind if I take a picture from you? Because when I'm going to tell this to my children and grandchildren, they will say, first he lost his wife, then he lost his mother, who died 2 months after my wife. Now he lost his brain. So I have a picture, I can show you the picture of the guy, it's a real guy. And the next day I got an email from him, and his email address was Emmanuel, so it was a real existing person. And he wrote, Ben, I couldn't believe my ears when you said that you were at the same conference in Prague. And then he wrote, your openness and your joy and your freedom really blessed me.
Yeah.
He wrote, I saw that exactly in him, openness, joy and freedom.
Yeah.
And if there's anything now I guard in my life, is openness, joy and freedom. And nobody's going to steal it from me. And I know if I stay close to Jesus, he'll keep me open, joyful and freedom.
Yeah.
I don't care now what kind of strange, weird pilgrim passes by, but if I feel I should talk with him, I don't hesitate to talk with him about Jesus.
Yeah.
It's the good news.
Yeah. It's amazing.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
I'm surprised. I look at myself and say, man, you are a shy boy and now you talk with anybody. It's amazing. It's not me. But I know God has changed my life.
Do you have children?
I have 2 children, 5 grandchildren. Last year, after 2 months, I felt guilty. I was still in Spain. So I wrote to my daughter. I wrote, I will be back on this date. And my daughter wrote back, who cares? We'll see when you're back. And the more they say that, the more I desire to go back.
Yeah, because they're here. They know you will do what you want to do.
I know what I want to do, but we have a good relation, yeah. Not a relation like this, perfect. A freedom. A freedom, they say, you are healthy, you like to spread the news, and you like to travel, go. And they really support it, and they know, they really support also this message that young people need to hear. Many people,
absolutely.
They have no idea in Europe. I speak with a group of Spanish young people. I said, have you ever heard good news about Jesus? Never heard about it. Man, we live in a world now, a non-Christian world, and we still think that we are somehow Christian in Spain too, tradition, religion. I like architecture, I like fiestas, but when it's mixed with religion, you get an ugly combination that doesn't draw people to God, it just makes them to more distance.
Yeah.
And many people will accuse the church, and they use it as an opportunity for not to believe. If the church is like that, why should I believe?
Yeah.
That's why we have a duty as Christians to show Jesus. He wants to live in us and through us, not to get into our lives, but also to get out of it.
Yeah, we can't give what we haven't received. If you don't walk towards Christ and look at him and ask him, can I have a conversation with you? We can't transmit something that we have not spoken to Christ with. People don't understand this.
No.
But when you encounter Christ, you know, he's a very human person.
Yeah.
You know, like speaking, like we're speaking here. And he didn't give a gospel that's so so high that you can't understand. It's very simple. And like you said, the way, the truth, and the life. I am the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody comes to the Father yeah. except through me. You know, everybody, you know, he had such a compelling way of dealing with people. You know, it's
amazing.
It's really amazing.
Yeah, and he said to his disciples, Jesus said to his disciples, without me, you can do nothing.
Yes.
When I wake up in the morning, I said, Lord, without you, they can do nothing. Well, it's a good starting point. Then yeah. you have nothing to lose.
Yeah.
Yeah, you only have to win. And I see, when I see the people that I meet every day and the things that happen and work here with a team of volunteers from different countries in unity.
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, from a Catholic point of view, I mean, many Catholics in Ireland, 90% of baptized Catholics don't go to any religious mass, any service. Yeah. 90% of baptized Catholics won't pick up the Bible, the Word of God, and read Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Just read the Gospel.
Just read it.
I mean, I look at the religious education books they have in Ireland, the Catholic ones, and we don't have basic scripture. You know, and I said to them, you know, you go to a religion class, the first thing you need is a Bible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, and you put the Bible in, and now you have the living Word of God.
Yeah. I met this Irish pilgrim, and he said to me, I talked to him about Jesus, and he said, I give you 2 more minutes. I said, you think I'm going to spend 2 more minutes of my life to try to convince you of what I believe? No, I just like to see people happy. And I know, forget about me, but the message of God's word can change lives.
Yes, absolutely. It's basic, the basic gospel, the message, you know.
Yeah. So what language would you like for, sorry, I'm going through
you're
the video.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
I'll end it here.